Wala ho silang collection sa estudyante. Ang meron, so
I'm
that
sorry, we're, I'm sorry, so I can disagree, ma'am. Ito po, lahat ng mga nagsumbong sa akin.
Sir, the
these
issue,
are the
student, I don't
These
think...
are the list of parents na nagsumbong sa akin, iba't ibang eskwelahan sa buong Pilipinas, na kung saan sila po ay sapilitang kinukolektahan ng mga electric fund at kung ano pang mga gamit sa eskwelahan, na meron man pong budget sa MOE ang DepEd for those things. Napagsabihan po ako noon na kung gusto ko pong baguhin yung pulisiya ng pangongolekta to PTA, gumawa po ako ng batas. Now, I don't have to, dahil nakita ko na po, very clear na sa akin, na meron naman pala talagang batas. Kaya lang, yung batas na yun ay hindi na-implement. Republic Act 4206, noong 1965, na-enact yan, which prohibits collection and even voluntary or otherwise from elementary schools sa public schools except for Red Cross, except for in fact the only once that was mentioned was Red Cross. Now, noong 1969, RA 5546 was enacted para ma-amend yung 4206. Dito po sa 5546, mas lalo naging malawak po yung prohibition sa collection. Maybe the good sponsor might want to react doon po sa dalawang batas na akin pong nabanggit.
Thank you. Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, the concern of the gentleman was raised during the hearing. And the Vice President Secretary of DepEd responded by mentioning Department Order Number 490 of 2022, which is a no fee, no collection policy. Tama ba yun? No fee, no collection policy, which they are strictly implementing. And it was further discussed during that hearing that there is the PTA in almost every school that does their own fundraising efforts. And it being a parent-initiated organization, they are allowed to do that. So we, in connection with the law that His Honor pointed out, that is exactly consistent with the department order of the department.
But the
Which
department order cannot supersede.
If I may continue, Your Honor.
Okay.
So the department order has the very same policy. No fee, no collection. The department and all their subordinates, meaning the teachers, are not allowed to initiate or to tolerate these collection efforts. But this does not prevent the parents from having their own fundraising. This system has been practiced for decades. Ayan, finally lumakas. This system has been practiced for decades and it has been a private initiative of the parents that has allowed many projects to see the light, no? Anything from gate, fencing, gardening, events. It's a PTA initiative, and I think that's why it was mentioned that if there is a desire to change that policy, there must be a law, because currently the DepEd order is consistent with the existing law mentioned by His Honor.
Okay, Mr. President, may I ask, the good sponsor kung sabi niya sa akin yung bang department order na yon at saan po doon sa dalawang batas na binanggit ko, RA 4206 and RA 5546, alin doon na nagsasabing pinapayagan na mangolekta ang mga eskwelahan o mga magulang para sa kontribusyon sa eskwelahan. Can you please show it to me? Maybe I can help the good sponsor para mas mapabilis tayo rito, if she will allow me to.
Your Honor, if His Honor can, Mr. President, if His Honor can give me a minute to just review, and then I will be happy to yield the floor, of course, anytime.
Yes, sure, session suspended for a minute.
Ang point ko lamang po dito, Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam, mag-implement na tayo ng policy. Meron tayong law, then dapat it's up to the executive para ma-implement itong law. Because the last time I was informed na gumawa ako ng batas para ma-implement na raw, mag-implement ng batas. Nagagawin ko, I don't have to because meron na palang dalawang batas, Your Honor.
Yes. Your Honor, Mr. President, His Honor is correct in his paraphrasing or delivering the provisions of RA 5546 kung saan ho, and I will just read it no para clear ang maintindihan din ng mga kasamahan natin yung issue po na malapit po sa puso ng ating kasamahan. The section 1 of RA 5546 states the sale of tickets and or the collection of contributions in any form whatsoever by any person for any project or purpose, whether voluntary or otherwise, from school children, students and teachers of public and private schools, colleges and universities is hereby prohibited. Tama po, sir, no? Yan, Mr. President, yan po ang tinutukoy ng ating kasamahan. Tama po. Tama ho ba?
I agree.
Yes, okay. So, nung ako ho ay nakikipag-diskusyon sa DepEd, aware po sila dito na bawal talaga ang collections of contributions in any form from school children, students, and teachers. And that is why in their Department Order Number 49 Series of 2022, known as the Promotion of Professionalism in the Implementation and Delivery of Basic Education Programs and Services, prohibits DepEd officials and employees from seeking contribution, support, solicitation of any kind or any kind of intervention from non-DepEd entities. It goes on to say, likewise, the department implements a no-fee collection policy wherein no fees shall be collected from learners in kindergarten up to grade 4, while fees on certain memberships may be collected from learners in grade 5 and above, strictly on a voluntary basis, Boys and Girl Scouts, Philippine National Red Cross, Parent Teachers Associations. So ito po yata, sir, ang implementing order na hinahanap nyo, Mr. President. Do I respond to His Honor's question by pointing out this DepEd Order Number 49?
Thank you, Mr. President, Your Honor. Pero can a department order supersedes a Republic Act?
Mr. President, in my humble legal opinion, this department order is consistent with the law. But I am very open to hear His Honor's concerns kung meron dito sa department order na inconsistent, kasi isa po ako sa naniniwala na hindi talaga dapat nagsusupersede ang isang department order. We are one with that.
Thank
and
you.
I let the record show that the minority floor leader is nodding his head because for more than a decade, magkakasama kami always reviewing this department order. Hindi ho tayo nagtotolerate na nag-exceed.
Exactly.
So, nagkakaisa po tayo dyan, Mr. President.
Pero dito po sa RA 5546, Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam, totally pinagbabawal ang any form of collections, voluntary or otherwise, except Red Cross, Girl Scout, Boy Scout, and then donors for the support of Barrio High School. And I have a definition of Barrio High School with me. Never did this RA mention about PTA.
Yes, Your Honor, we noted that the mention of PTA is now in that department order. Upon further review and discussion with the DepEd, we are now looking at the entirety of RA 5546, wherein it states... Yes, thank you. Mr. President, when we look at RA 5546, Section 1, and I will read it again, the sale of tickets and or the collection of contributions in any form whatsoever by any person for any project or purpose, whether voluntary or otherwise, from 1, school children, 2, students, and 3, teachers are hereby prohibited. So in the case of the PTA, Your Honor, what has been the policy of DepEd since 1969, just to be clear, it is not the policy of this administration alone, but since 1969, nila ang policy, is that there is a total ban on collection from the children, the school children, the students, and other teachers. But they recognize PTA as a separate entity that on their own have their own rules and guidelines and may on their own come up with fundraisings that are voluntary in nature.
Fundraisings, okay.
Well, just to be clear, Your Honor, okay. That is my own choice of words,
that's
Mr. President, yung fundraising. No? Okay. I use it generically po,
Madam,
Mr. President.
Meron ba diyang batas na kung saan, batas tayo, dinidefine ang meaning and function ng PTA? Alam niyo po ba yun?
Dito
na meron?
Sa RA 5546, wala hong banggit
wala.
Ng PTA.
Tama. Wala
pero,
po.
I will ask DepEd if there are
no,
any
don't
other...
No, don't ask DepEd.
You don't
bahala.
Need to know. Okay.
Ako nang bahala.
Yes, Mr. President.
PD 603, December 10, 1974, define ang meaning ng PTA. At nowhere here na nagsasabi ang PTA pwedeng mangolekta. Ang sinasabi rito, ang PTA ay isang programa, samahan, na para tulungan ng mga estudyante sa kanilang academic performance. Kung ano mga problema ng estudyante, anong problema ng mga magulang at teachers tungkol sa estudyante to enhance their participation sa eskwelahan, yun po yung purpose. Look at PD 603, ma'am. I'll give you a minute. PD 603, December 10, 1974. It is a forum being provided by the law para yung mga magulang at ng mga estudyante at guro ay magkaroon ng pagkakataon mapag-usapan yung welfare ng mga estudyante. Yun pong pinakabuod. Never doon sa PD na yan did mention na pwedeng mangolekta ang PTA ng contribution o collection para sa mga proyekto ng anumang mga proyekto sa isang eskwelahan.
Yes. Mr. President, I will respond to His Honor's observation on the definition of PTA. Umpisahan ko po kung ano tong PD 603, no? This is the Child and Welfare Code. Familiar po tayo dyan. It's basically a law that governs, is meant to protect children. And Section 77, Section 77, just to be clear, malawak ho itong batas na ito kasi ito din ho ang naging foundation ng Foster Care Act na naging basis ng mga amendments natin on foster care law. So it's a very general law, quite detailed, no, in various ways of protecting children. So there is a section on home and school, chapter 2 po ito. And Article 77, as his honor correctly points out, mentions Parent Teachers Association. It states every elementary and secondary school shall organize a parent-teacher association for the purpose of providing a forum for the discussion of problems and their solutions relating to the total school program and for ensuring the full cooperation of parents in the efficient implementation of such programs. All parents who have children enrolled in a school are encouraged to be active members of its PTA and to comply with whatever obligation and responsibility such membership entails. Parent-teacher associations all over the country shall aid the municipal and the local authorities and school officials in the enforcement of juvenile delinquent control measures and in the implementation of programs and activities to promote child welfare. Mr. President, in response to His Honor's concern or conclusion that the Parent Teachers Association do not have the authority to collect. Tama ho, no, sir? Mr. President, that is the question, no? That the Parent Teacher Association, by definition here in PD 603, do not have the authority to collect. That is the question,
let
correct?
Me rephrase what I said. Mr. President, Your Honor, I want a clear definition in our law that states that the PTA is allowed to collect contributions voluntary or otherwise. Saan po sa ating konstitusyon? Saan po sa ating batas? Yun po gusto ko para maging malino po sa ating lahat.
Yes,
dapat
understood.
Po nandito, meron po ba? In fact, ang nakita ko lamang po definition ng PTA, which is sabi mo very vague, general, is PD 603, pinakamalapit. However, din sa PD 603, hindi po sinasabi na ang PTI ay binuo para mangolekta sa mga estudyante ang mga eskwelahan. Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam.
Mr. President, I just needed to confer with DepEd if tama po ang intindi ko. So in Article 77 of PD 603, which I had just read into the record, as I said, it states there that that every elementary school shall organize ito nga hong PTA relating to the total school program to ensure full cooperation of parents in the efficient implementation of such programs to address. They are meant to create a forum to address the problems and the solutions. So the practice of DepEd has been to support the to allow the PTA to follow the mandate of Article 77, and if they need to raise funds to be able to address these problems and solutions, including the implementation of the programs, then they are governed by their own guidelines in implementing those
programs. Sorry, Mr.
including
President.
Yung at tapusin ko lang po,
sige po,
including yung fundraising. Yan po ang naging practice ng DepEd since 1969 po.
Practice is different from what the law says. There, yes, you can practice anything you want. Pwede mag-practice ang DepEd. lahat ng klaseng practice na gusto nila. Pero dapat nandoon sa batas. Pero kung wala sa batas yan, then yung practice na yon ay labag sa batas.
There
again,
is actually, Mr. President, no prohibition.
Sinabi mo kasi, Madam, fundraising. So pwede mag-fundraising ang DepEd. It's been a practice through the DepEd. Magkakaroon silang fundraising under PD603. Pero, Mr. President, Your Honor, sa PD603, wala talaga ako makita rito, kahit na letter by letter, tinitingnan ko, wala talaga nagsabi rito na pwede mag-fundraising, na pwedeng humingi ng contribution, humingi ng tinatawag na voluntary contribution. Wala talaga. So it seems to me na yung DepEd ay gumagawa-gawa ng sarili nila ng guidelines sa isang batas. Gumagawa sila ng sarili nilang IRR.
Mr. President, I'll go back to what the Republic Act states. It prevents, it prohibits collection and contribution from students. And so the policy of DepEd has been to allow the PTAs to follow their own guidelines wherein contributions among the parents are allowed. So okay. to be clear, Mr. President, importante po na maliwanag yung pagsagot ko sa napakamahalagang tanong ng ating kasamahan. Bawal talaga ang pagkolekta sa estudyante, and that is being honored by DepEd. In other words, hindi pwedeng maglabas ang DepEd, ang principal, ang teacher ng request request for contribution na ibinibigay sa estudyante. Bawal po talaga yon.
Bawal. But, so kung bawal po, bakit correct. Po nangungulekta pa rin sila sa mga estudyante, especially po
Mr.
sa mga hirap?
Mr. President, I would like to clarify, never po sila nangungulekta sa estudyante. Wala okay. ho silang collection sa estudyante. Ang meron,
I beg to disagree, ma'am. Ito po, lahat ng mga nagsumbong sa akin. These are the list of parents na nagsumbong sa akin, iba't ibang eskwelahan sa buong Pilipinas, na kung saan sila po ay sapilitang kinukolektahan ng mga electric fan at kung ano pang mga gamit sa eskwelahan, na meron man pong budget sa MOE, ang DepEd, for those things.
Yes. Mr. President, first of all, may I request that list is submitted
so that we can give it
to DepEd, kasi I believe they have committed in the hearing pa lang na any violation po ay iimbestigahan naman po nila. They made that commitment po. The only item left for the discussion on the floor right now is yung authority mismo ng PTA. So any direct contribution o collection sa estudyante, talaga hong iimbestigahan nila. So tama ang pagkaintindi ko, Mr. President, sa issue is, so si PTA ba pwedeng mangolekta? And ang sinasabi po sa atin ng DepEd, the policy since 1969 has been to recognize the PTA's authority to decide among themselves. They have their own rules, they have their own guidelines to do their fundraising, that is a generic term that I'm using, among the parents. Hindi to sa bata, hindi apektado yung pagpasok ng bata, hindi apektado ang grade ng bata. Bakit ginagawa ng parents yon? Kasi kulang ang pondo. Yung sinabi ng ating kasamahan na nasa MOOE yan, meron yan pambili ng electric fan. Idagdag ko na rin doon, ano yung mga kakulangan, di ba? Yung magpaganda ng garden, driveway, entrance, kung ano pa man. Lahat naman po yan nilalagyan ng MOOE. Pero if I may call the attention of our chairman, talaga naman hong wala na ho tayo, nagbibigay ho tayo ng maraming pondo, but hindi ho talaga nakokompleto, no? In fact, ako na magsasabi, because baka may magtanong, yung mga repairs, no? Pagpalagay mo ng may electric fan dun sa loob ng classroom, o di kaya yung picture na pinakita ni Senator Bongo, medyo bumagsak yung kisame, lahat po yon falls under repairs of basic facilities. Pero natanggalan po yan ng pondo, na ilipat po sa ibang pondo yan, hindi ho ng Senado. So may mga issue pong ganyan. I want to assure our colleague that hanggat makakaya, sinusuportahan ng ating chairman yung ating recommendation to increase the MOOE. So that basic principle, I think everyone in the Senate supports his honor na mapondohan sana ng lahat na yan. So remaining na lang po yan kung ano ho hanggang saan ang kakayahan ng PTA to among themselves decide to fundraise parent to parent. I cannot add to my answer kasi yan po ang policy. Hindi ko naman ho kayo bobolahin, Mr. President, na iba yung policy. Yan po ang policy na ginagamit po nila. So kung may recommendation, suggestions ang ating kasamahan, this representation is happy to relay at nandito naman ang DepEd para pakinggan ang mga suggestion ng ating kasamahan.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, the good sponsor, Honorable Congresswoman Pia Cayetano. Senator Pia Cayetano, sorry. Thank you. Pero gusto ko lang pong balikan, Mr. President, Your Honor, yung sinabi mo, it's been a long time practice. Tama?
Policy po.
Policy, okay, sige. I stand corrected. It's been a long time policy na pinapractice sa DepEd for so many years na hindi ka, ilan sa atin hindi pa pinapanganak dito. Of course, ako pinanganak na ako dyan. Pero dapat a policy should be dictated by the law. So is there a law na kung saan sinasang-ayunan ng policy na sinasabi niyo matagal na pinapractice ng mga taga-DepEd? Dapat lahat ng mga bagay na ginagawa sa ating mga eskwelahan, lalo sa DepEd, na who's receiving a lot, lots and lots of budget by the billions, dapat nandoon nakasaad sa batas. Hindi yes. Pwede po silang gagawa-gawa ng sarili ng policy na wala po sa batas. Dapat lahat po ng polisiya nandoon po.
Mr. President, may I respond to that statement? Mr. President, as I said, no, kaya ho ako nag-abalang ipaliwanag na ang PD 603 is a very broad law intended to protect the rights of children. Kaya nga po Child and Youth Welfare Code ang pangalan nito. And there is just one chapter on home and school, which is only two articles. So, dito po sa articles na to, at binasa ko naman on record, yung pag-create ho ng PTA, wala na hong detalye yon. The fact, Mr. President, that there is no prohibition, that there is no provision that specifically or expressly prohibits the PTA from engaging in certain acts to pursue their mandate.
Yes, there is.
In Mr. President, if I may just continue. My statement is the fact that there is no provision that expressly prohibits the PTA from pursuing their mandate is in itself an accepted principle that there is no violation. It is a rule of statutory construction that what is not expressly or impliedly prohibited by law may be done. So yan ho ang ating statutory constructions when it comes to prohibited acts. So pag sinabi po natin bawal ito, then we need to produce that law that prohibits it. And so we do have yung dalawang RA na binanggit naman ng ating kasamahan. Meron nga hong RA na nagbabawal.
Yes.
But that is why I have been repeatedly explaining that since 1969, ang implementation ng ating DepEd dito, they believe that they have been implementing this in the true spirit of the law na nagsasabing bawal mangolekta sa bata. They cannot collect contributions from school children, students, and teachers. Yun ho ang specific wording of the law.
Exactly. Sige, pagbigyan ko po, I yield my floor to
Mr. President,
Majority
yes,
Leader.
Yes, Minority Floor Leader.
Thank you, with the permission of my colleagues. The good sponsor mentioned statutory construction, which I used to teach in law school. We have to harmonize, and I'm thankful for the discussion. At least we brought out the RA 5546, and then Article 77 of the Child and Youth Welfare Code. Kung makikita po natin, yung RA, bawal mangolekta sa bata. Okay. Actually, sino kinokolektahan mo kung nangongolekta ka sa bata of elementary school age? Hindi ba magulang din? So if you look at the spirit of the law, bawal mangolekta sa bata at sa kanyang magulang. Ang proviso sa dulo, kung out of the goodness of the heart of the parent, willingly, without any prompting or solicitation, magdo-donate siya sa school, hindi bawal yun. Okay. And then, if you look at Article 77, shall organize the PTA, in-enumerate ngayon yung purpose ng PTA. Wala po dun because it should solicit funds to financially help the school. Wala rin po dun sa Article 77 yun. So if we harmonize the two provisions, not only looking at the letter, but also looking at the spirit, I would tend to agree with the point of our interpellator, Senator Tulfo, na bawal. And if there is a department order na may interpret na pwede for the PTA to prompt or solicit or to ask contributions from the parents, let's review this department order because in my humble opinion, it violates the law, Mr. President. So thank you for the time, sir.
Thank you, Minority Leader.
Kung meron man kayong mga komento tungkol sa mga isyong ito, maaari kayong magbigay ng mga reaksyon sa comment section na makikita sa ibaba ng bidyong ito. Maraming salamat. At kung ikaw ay interesado ng mga bidyong tulad nito, mangyaring suportahan ang channel na ito sa pamamagitan ng pagpindot ng like, pag-share ng mga video at kung bago ka pa lang sa channel na ito, please subscribe sa channel na ito at pindutin ang notification bell at piliin ang all upang maabisuhan ka para sa mga paparating pang mga videos.